And here's the six iron. This is heading towards the green. And this putt could save par. This one's about 3 feet away. And after that hole, he will stay right where he is on the leaderboard. And next up is a par four, folks. I don't think he'll be too pleased with that shot. Nice shot. I think you'll like that. And they're about 3 feet away here. And that one will drop. And as we check the standings, he's still holding down first place after that one. Now, the 13th hole. I think this one's going to find the short grass. And about 100 yards to the pin from here. And this one's looking pretty good. And this putt is for birdie. And sitting at 7 under for the day after that one. And that means he's first overall on the leaderboard. And setting up now on the 14th hole. Well, this one's looking like it's finding the fairway. From about 145 yards out. Here is the pitching wedge. This could be good. It's heading for the green here. Well, that shot actually ended up in the rough. From here, it's about 10 feet away. And that putt drops for par. And he is just really stacking the birdies here today on the scorecard. And now setting up for the next par 4 hole. Well, I'm pretty sure this is going to land in the fairway here. And I think he's going to like that. And about 22 feet to the cup from here. Oh. And this one's for par. And no change for him leaderboard wise after that hole. And setting up for the par 3 hole. Here's a 9-iron. And this shot's looking pretty good. All right, and the putter's coming out now. And this one's for birdie. And a nice putt there. And he's gonna stick to first place after that one. OK. Okay, and moving on to the 17th now. Well, I'm not quite sure where this one's going to end up. About 7 feet to go here. Ooh, I thought that was gonna go. This putt's about a 2-footer. And after that one, sitting at 8 under par for the day. And moving on to the 18th hole. He appears to be heading for the fairway here. And about 215 yards out from here. This is the 3-iron, I believe. This one's looking pretty good. Fantastic work on this par 5, hitting the green in 2. And this next putt for a 61 on their final round. And the putt drops for eagle. And just like that, Luke, check this out. We have a winner, third win on the web.com tour for him.
And don't forget, John, this win also gives them their PGA Tour card. I think they'll be celebrating hard and fast tonight, John. They've deserved it. Well, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of John, I'm Luke Elby. Great to have your company.
And welcome to the PGA Tour opener for the season. I'm Luke Elby, joined alongside, as always, John McCarthy. And John, always love the first event, particularly for a rookie. Their excitement and anticipation is magnified.
And I guess, like, there's got to be an immense amount of work that goes into this just to get them to this level. What kind of extra skills do they need to play at this kind of high level with this incredible field that they have here today?
Well, of course, the depth of talent gets even greater. We're against the world's best right here. But the one thing that they need to maintain is what they did to get here is what they need to continue. No point changing the plan now that you've made it to the big stage.
Right.
If you're good enough to be a PGA Tour pro, well, that's what got you here. Keep it going. Just improve your weaknesses and play to your strengths.
And just kind of, yeah, and just keep that trust. Trust your game and kind of go with that flow and try to ride that out.
Absolutely. You don't want to get too far ahead of yourself and think about all the big money on offer and what could happen if you win. It's just stick to the processes and let the outcomes take care of themselves.
Great. Well, that's a great way to kick this event off. And let's check back in after nine holes and we'll see how this golfer's faring then. How's that sound?
Looking forward to seeing the action.
And starting today's round off at one under par. And setting up for this next tee off. Wind could be an issue here. Let's see. Well, this one's looking like it's in the fairway. And about 155 yards out. Going with the 8-iron. And this one's heading towards the green. And this for the birdie. And that putt will drop. And he's moving on up on the leaderboard after that hole. And now setting up on the par 3. Going with the 9-iron here. This one's looking good. All right, and now he's on. And about 6 feet to go here. And that one goes for birdie. And he is moving up on the leaderboard after that hole. And now the 4th hole. And a promising looking shot here. And about 165 yards to the pin. And here's an 8-iron. This one's looking good, folks. Very well played golf shot. Hitting this par 5 and 2, it's going to set up some serious possibilities. And the eagle will drop. And currently sitting at 5 under for the day after that one. Okay, and here is the 5th hole. And it's looking like this is bound for the short stuff. I think you'll like that. And this one's for birdie. And he's still at the top of the leaderboard after that one. And moving on to the sixth here. Heading for the green. Well, the approach did find the green, but quite a long distance putt ahead. Ooh, and just inches away. And this for the par. And after that one, there's 6 under for the day. And now teeing off on this par 4. And just launched this drive. This one's a 9-footer. For the birdie. And no change in his leaderboard status after that hole. And setting up for the par 5 hole. This one's looking pretty good so far. Okay, about 165 yards to the pin. Well, I think this is heading to the rough. And in the end, this actually ended up on the green. Goodness. And this one's for birdie. And finishing this hole out with a solid putt. And he's going to stay right there where he was on the leaderboard. No change in the ranking. And now setting up for the par 4 tee off. And pretty sure he's going to like that. And about 160 yards to the pin. Going with the 8-iron here. Well, this is definitely heading towards the green. And that approach is on the green with some distance left. Oh goodness, that was almost in. And tapping in for the par. And as he finishes up here on the front nine, Luke, he's found himself in a pretty favorable spot.
Oh, John, I love this part of the tournament. It's when it really heats up. And having the lead going into the final nine holes is the best position to be in. But everyone's gunning for the title. Will they have what it takes down the stretch?
Thanks for that, Luke.
Going with the six iron. About 15 feet to the cup from here.
And that putt's going to drop for par.
And after that one, he's still managing to hold on to first place. And moving on to the 11th hole. Okay, this one's looking pretty good. Okay, and from 150 yards out. Going with the 8-iron. This is going towards the green here. And with that, he's on the green. This one's about 10 feet from the cup. Ooh, unfortunate. Yes, about 3 feet to the cup from here.
And that putt drops on in for par. And after that one, 8-under is the score.
And that also means he's in first place on the leaderboard. And now teeing off on the par 5. It's looking like it's heading into the fairway. And about 170 yards to the pin. And here's an 8-iron. And heading for the green. And that would have been huge. Just missed the double eagle there. And tapping it home for the eagle. And 10-under is the score after that hole. All right, let's see what happens on the 13th hole here. Taking a shot with the pitching wedge. And this one's definitely heading towards the green. This putt's for birdie. Oh, my lands. That was very close. And this putt is for par. And no change ranking-wise after that hole. And teeing off on this par 4. I don't think we'll find some fairway here. And this next shot, setting up below the hole.
And looks like a 6-iron. This is heading towards the green. From here, about 33 feet. Ooh, almost, almost. Let's see how things are shaping up on the leaderboard. And after that one, he will stay at the top of the leaderboard. And now setting up for the par four. And this is looking fairway bound. Yeah, about 110 yards to the pin from here. Unlucky on that approach shot. Just not enough club on that one. And to save par. And that one will drop. All right, and currently sitting 10 under after that one. And that means he's first overall on the leaderboard. And there's a long bomb, folks. Look at that. And about 120 yards out from here. Looking good. From 29 feet out. And oh my, what a putt that was. Very long putt right into the cup. And after that one, he's going to stay right where he was on the leaderboard. And number 17. I think he'll like that. And about 235 to the pin from here. And here's a 3-iron. And this one's looking pretty good. Very well played. And hitting this par 5 and 2 is going to set up some nice eagle opportunities here. This could be the shot, folks. And this putt's for birdie. And tapping in for birdie. And as we check the standings, he's still in first after that one. Now teeing up for the final hole of the round.
And if this putt drops, they will have a 59 final round score. Ooh, just missing here. This one's about 2 feet from the cup. And that putt will go for par. And he's done it, Luke. He proved himself today, and he has played well enough to become the winner of this event.
Oh, you can see the elation on his face. What a performance. He deserved the victory right from the get-go, but this will do a lot for his confidence. I look for him to have a huge season from here on in. I'm sure you'll agree we saw some pretty good golf today. Thanks for tuning in.
Everyone, a great event to be playing in. It's the Champions Invitational. My name is Luke Elvey. Alongside me, as always, is John McCarthy, and we're excited to bring this day's action to you. And John, getting off to a good start is paramount. How do the players have to play this opening hole?
Well, Luke, it's a beautiful course here at Faxon Park, and this first hole, par four, is no different. There's water to the left as the fairway gets cut in two. If you play up the right, I think most people will, you can get a slightly better view of that green, which is flanked by bunkers to the right and left. Let's see how this one goes.
Thanks, John. Conditions are ripe for scoring, so let's see if they can go low.
Now he's on the green. Time for putting. And this putt is for birdie. Oh, that was very close. And starting the round off with a par, not bad. And just about to tee off on this par three. Shot's looking pretty good.
about 13 feet away. And that'll drop for birdie. And after that hole, one under for the day. Next up is a par four, folks. Putt's looking to be about 2 feet for the bird. And sitting at 2 under for the day. And now we find ourselves at the fourth hole tee off. Probably not happy about that shot. And this is for birdie. And finishing the hole with a solid putt. And he will stay right where he is on the leaderboard after that hole. And now teeing off on the par five. Nothing wrong with that. From here, about 230 to the pin. Pretty sure that's the 5 wood. This one's looking pretty good. And that's a pretty inspiring shot just there, hitting this par 5 green in 2 definite eagle possibilities. Ooh, that would have been good. This puts about 3 feet away. And that one will drop for birdie. And after that hole, he's still in first place. and moving on to the sixth. This one's looking good. And this for the birdie. So close. This one's about 2 feet from the cup. And that putt will drop for par. And currently sitting at 4 under for the day. And now we find ourselves on the 7th hole tee off. Well, someone's looking pretty good. And from 165 yards out. Going with the 8-iron here. Not good. This is not going to be good. And nothing to write home about on that approach shot. And since he's been hitting those greens pretty regularly today, he's probably not going to feel too bad about that. And this putt to save par. And a nice putt. And he's sticking to the same position he was at after that hole. And now setting up for this par 5. And I am pretty sure he's going to like that. And about 5 feet from the cup. And that one drops for the birdie. Okay, and he's still in first place, ladies and gentlemen. And now the 9th hole. And I think he will be pleased with that. Going with a pitching wedge here. Looks like this is going a bit long. And in the end, I think that's going to play on the green here. And that one will go for birdie. And as he finishes up the front nine, Luke, he's found himself in a pretty good spot, if you ask me.
Well, I love this stage of any golf tournament. It's when the pressure really starts to build. If there's any weaknesses in your game, it's going to be found out now. Do they have the courage to take it all the way to the trophy? We'll have to find out.
Cheers, Luke. And this shot's looking promising. And about a buck 10 to the pin from here. And this one's heading towards the green. And this putt's for birdie. This shot could be just right. Oh, and it just didn't drop. And with a tap, they'll get a par. And they're six under on the day after that hole. And now the 11th hole. Well, so far so good for this one. Fantastic. And hitting this par 5 in 2 is going to open up some real interesting possibilities. And this putt's about a 2-footer here. And that one goes in for the bird. And no change in the standings after that hole. And now we find ourselves on the 12th. This could be good. It's heading for the green here. And this putt is for birdie. And from that length, that is just fine work. And after that one, he's still holding on to the first place spot. And now setting up for the next par four hole. Well, I think this one's going to find the short grass. One's heading for the green. And with that, he will be putting. This one's about a 7-footer. Ooh, that was very close. And this putt is for par. Quite a few birdies on the scorecard today. That's got to be good for him. And next up, we have a par 5 hole. Well, I think this one's going to find the fairway. From 240 yards out. Going with the 3-iron. And let's see if he re-hits or takes the drop. He's definitely in the water, though. Going with the 5-wood here. This is going towards the green here. And about 16 feet left to go. Oh my gracious, that was close. And this putt is for bogey. Nice little putt. And no change for him leaderboard-wise after that hole. And moving on to the 15th here. He's got to be pleased with that. Okay, and 135 yards to the pin. And heading for the green. And this putt is for birdie. And they are sitting at 7 under par for the event. And now teeing off on this par 4. And this putt's about 7 feet to the cup. And that putt will drop for birdie. And after that one, he's still in first place. Okay, and setting up on the 17th tee. And this one's definitely heading towards the green. All right, he's on the green now. 11 feet to the cup. Oh, that was so, so close. This putt's about 3 feet away. And that par putt will drop. And no change in his leaderboard status after that hole. Teeing it up here on the 18th. And I think he's gonna like that. Okay, about 140 yards to go. And that is not bound for the dance floor. Too much club. And this next putt is for a final round score of 64. And a decent little putt there. And he's done it. He has played some incredible golf here today, and that's why he's walking away with the win.
Now, this is a big deal, John. This victory secures so many outcomes, particularly a chance to play for the draw in the FedEx Cup playoffs. On behalf of our hard-working production crew and all the team in the truck, I'm Luke Elvey, saying so long for now. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello everyone and welcome to the Shriners Hospitals for Children Open. My name is Luke Elvey. Alongside me, as always, is John McCarthy, and we're excited to bring this day's action to you.
Hi Luke, glad to be here. Very excited to take in some golf at TPC Summerlin. Could you tell us a little bit about the first hole here?
The opening hole here at TPC Summerlin really sets the tone for your round. It's a more a ball-in-play golf course than one that you'd overpower. Something less than driver positioned around that bunker on the right here off the tee is the line to attack this green. It's a green that sits just a little lower down than the fairway and is really receptive to your wedge shots. It's a good hole to get your round underway on.
Thanks, Luke. We'll talk to you later on. And this one's for birdie. And finishing the hole with a solid putt. And currently sitting at one under for the day. And the wind could be an issue on this next hole. We're gonna have to see how this tee shot goes. And he's probably not happy with that. And as he sets this next shot up, he's deep in the rough, folks.
pretty sure he's going to like that one.
And this putt's right around 2 feet. For the birdie. And after that hole, 2 under. Now let's see what this third hole has in store.
And I think he'll like that.
And from 155 yards out. Going with the 8-iron.
This is heading towards the green.
And that is some fantastic club work on this par 5 green, hitting it in 2. Oh, I thought that was going to go. And this for the birdie. And after that hole, he will stay right where he is on the leaderboard. And now setting up for the par 4 tee off.
Going right through the brush on this one.
And he can't be pleased with himself after that one.
And now that that shot has ended up in the fairway, let's see what the next one holds.
And to save the par.
And a nice putt. And he's gonna stick to first place after that one.
Okay, let's see what the fifth has in store today.
Going with the 9-iron, and it seems the 8-iron was a bit too much club here.
This one's about 7 feet away.
Drop for par. And after that hole, 3 under on the day.
And teeing off on this par 4.
And he's probably gonna like that. And nothing wrong with that shot.
And from 25 feet.
Oh, that was close.
And for the par.
And
And that one will drop. And no change ranking-wise after that hole. And now setting up for the par four.
I think he'll like that.
And this one's for birdie. And a decent putt. And he's still at the top of the leaderboard after that one. And now setting up on this par three. Looking good. Feet to go here. And this shot is looking scary good right now. 5 feet to go here. And that one's gonna go for par. And currently sitting at 4 under for the day. And on to the 9th hole. Well, this one's looking like it's in the fairway. From here, about 225 to the pin. Going with the 5-wood. Missing the approach on that one. And the wind got the best of that one, I think. And this putt's for birdie. All right, let's take a peek at the leaderboard now. And Luke, as we finish the front nine and get ready to tackle the back, what are you looking forward to? It's a beautiful course. Is there anything you want to bring to our attention?
The finish here at TPC Summerlin is one of the best on tour. So many scoreable holes where players can make a late surge. 15, 16, 17. It's all part of that thrilling finish. And if they can get the lead walking up the last, well, they'll enjoy a stroll to victory.
Thanks, Luke.
About 12 feet to go to get to that cup. Ooh, and it just misses. And this putt's for par. And finishing this one with a good putt. And after that one, currently sitting at 5 under for the day. And that also means he is in first place on the leaderboard.
And he's got to be happy with that. Oh, you'll probably like that.
And this one's for birdie. Oh, and a very good attempt at what was a lengthy putt. And now let's take a look at the leaderboard. And he's going to stay right there where he was on the leaderboard. No change in the ranking. And moving along now on the 12th hole. And just a powerful drive here.
And I think you'll like that.
And this one's about 6 feet away.
For the birdie.
And he's still in first place after that hole. Next up is the par five. Well, this one's looking like it's finding the fairway. And from here, it's about 240 yards to the pin.
Okay, and hitting this par 5 in 2 is going to set up some definite eagle possibilities. Oh my, this is looking very, very promising. And ladies and gentlemen, the eagle putt drops.
And he will stay right where he is on the leaderboard after that hole. Okay, let's see what this tee shot has in store on the 14th. I think this is looking a bit long. And this putt is essential for saving par. And that one's right in the cup. And sitting at 8 under par after that hole. And setting up now on the 15th.
Well, I'm pretty sure this is going to land in the fairway here. And it looks like he's going through the branches here on this one. This putt's for birdie. Finishing this hole with a solid putt. And after that one, he will stay at the top of the leaderboard. And setting up on the 16th tee. And he's probably not too happy about that. Fantastic work on this par five, hitting the green in two. Ladies and gentlemen, the eagle has landed. And after that one, he's going to stay right where he was on the leaderboard. And let's see what the 17th has in store. Going with the 9-iron. Well, this is definitely heading towards the green. 12 feet to the cup. Ooh, and it just doesn't drop. This putt's about a 2-footer. And that one will drop for par. And currently sitting at 11 under par after that one. And now, teeing up for the final hole of the round. And it's looking like this is bound for the short stuff. From 145 yards out. Here's a 9-iron, and this shot's looking pretty good. And that approach is on the green, and a lengthy putt in the near future. And they'll tap it in and end the round with a par. And he's done it, folks. You are now looking at the Shriners Hospital for Children Open champion.
This will be a great victory on their resume. To win anywhere is a big deal. But right here in Las Vegas at the Shriners Hospitals for Children Open, top victory this month. On behalf of John McCarthy, I'm Luke Elvey. Look forward to your company next time. Thank you.